In this how-to video, I will show you how to validate that databases meet Center for Internet Security Compliance version 1.1.0 standards using Oracle Enterprise Manager auditing rule violation, and for once that don't remediate them using automated corrective action. In this example, we will specifically focus on user auditing roles within Enterprise Manager. Starting from Enterprise Manager Compliance Library Standards page, you will see the out of the box CIS compliance standards and versions available to validate databases against cluster database, database instance, pluggable database. In this example, select CIS standard version 1.1.0 for an Oracle database 19c pluggable database. Click on associated targets. This navigates to the target association page. Click add. In the pop-up box, choose the applicable pluggable databases as it appears. Click select. We'll be navigated back to the compliance standard association page where you can see evaluation status enabled. Click OK. Save the association pop-up window as appears. Click yes. Information pop-up box appears saying that compliance standard submitted to target for processing. Click OK. From the enterprise menu, compliance, click dashboard. We navigate to the compliance dashboard page. Under the compliance summary standard page, here Oracle 19c CIS standards will be displayed, showing information about compliant targets, non-compliant targets, which we have attached to pluggable databases, and critical violations, which has shown here 302 warning and minor warning. Here you can see, you can view log audit. Let us look at audit logging policies and procedure. Under unified auditing rule, we have multiple violations. Let's select auditing rule violation. Ensure the alter role action audit is enabled. Next, as you see under summary, each pluggable databases as violation. Let's click on violation events tab. Let us choose the PDB target CDB1_PMCLD1 that will take us to the detail of alter role action audit. The recommendation is we need to enable the alter roles policy for this particular role. So let's choose corrective actions, submit from library. The pop-up corrective action CS alter role PDB comes up. We can see by click here for view the execution result. This will take you to the jobs page where you can confirm that remediation steps are successfully complete. You will notice by selecting the CIS compliance page on the results page, you will notice that violation count has decreased from 302 to 301. Clicking on CIS compliance, this will direct you to a page detailing individual rules and then violation. Let's examine the rule, ensure the alter role audit is enabled for the pluggable database CDB1_PMCLD1. As you see, the count has been zero. The number of violations is reduced from 1 to 0. Let's click on violation events tab. For the pluggable database CDB1_PMCLD1, the violation events tab no longer displays this violation. This indicates that with our corrective auto remediate action, we have successfully remediated the auditing violation for this rule.